This regular expression can be used to evaluate user input to determine whether it is a valid zip code in the United States. Now, let's walk through the process the regular expression evaluator would use to test user input. The first character, a caret, must match the beginning of the string. The backslash D code represents numeric digits. Because it follows the caret, it means the first symbol must be a number. Because it has a bracket 5 bracket after it, it means there must be 5 numbers in a row. The next code is actually a group, the set of characters surrounded by parentheses. This group has a question mark after it, indicating that the entire group is optional. Therefore, it's okay that it doesn't exist in the user input. The last character, a dollar sign, indicates the end of the regular expression. If the regular expression didn't include this, the user input could have some extra characters following the zip code. By including the caret at the beginning of the regular expression and the dollar sign at the end, the regular expression requires the user input to match exactly, with no extra characters at the beginning or end. So we now know that the user did provide a valid zip code because it matched the regular expression. Now let's evaluate user input that includes the optional 4-digit extension to the zip code. As before, the first characters match the beginning of the user input. This time, though, there's additional input to be evaluated. The first character in the group matches the hyphen. The next several characters match the next 4 numeric digits, completing the evaluation of the user input. Now let's consider what would happen if the user entered invalid input accidentally. As before, the first several characters match the valid zip code. Now, the regular expression evaluator attempts to match the optional group with the next character, which is a space. It doesn't match, but that's okay, because the group is optional. It's indicated by the question mark following the group. Next, the regular expression evaluator would attempt to match the dollar sign symbol, which represents the end of the user input. It tries to match this to the space that follows the valid zip code, but the space isn't the end of the user input, so the regular expression evaluator has to reject the user input because it's not a valid zip code.